This is a question 4b. For good dielectric, derive the expression for alpha, beta, velocity and intrinsic impedance. This question is given for 8 marks, set 2, April, May 2017. It is a very, very important question which is asked several times in the examination. So, very simple question. Let us see how to solve this question. So, for good dielectrics, the ratio sigma by omega epsilon is much less than 1, or the conductivity of good dielectrics is much less than omega epsilon. Now we use this condition to derive alpha, beta, velocity and intrinsic impedance of the medium. Now as you know that the attenuation constant alpha, the general formula is given as omega into square root of mu epsilon by 2 into square root of 1 plus sigma square by omega square epsilon square minus 1. We use this formula to derive alpha. So now, as you know that the binomial expansion of 1 plus x power n is equal to 1 plus nx plus n into n minus 1 by 2 factorial into x square plus so on. Now let us apply this relation to 1 plus sigma square by omega square epsilon square whole power half. Since it is written as 1 plus sigma square whole square by whole power half, from this what is n? 1 by 2 x is this. So therefore 1 plus nx, so that is sigma square by 2 omega square epsilon square. Epsilon square, this is approximately equal to, next x square will become, so sigma by omega epsilon whole power 4. Since sigma by omega epsilon is much less than 1, so neglect higher order terms. Why? Because the ratio sigma by omega epsilon is much less than 1. So substitute this relation here in this alpha formula. So therefore alpha is equal to omega into square root of mu epsilon by 2 into, so this term is written as 1 plus sigma square by 2 omega square epsilon square minus 1. So 1 gets cancels out, 1 gets cancels out, from which alpha, the attenuation constant is written as omega square, it will come omega gets cancels out. So this sigma square, it will come out as sigma by 2 into 2, it will come out as 2, and it is given as square root of mu by epsilon. So this is the attenuation constant formula in good dielectrics. Now let us check the phase shift constant beta. The phase shift constant beta. As you know that the beta formula, so this is the attenuation constant. The phase shift constant beta is equal to omega into square root of mu epsilon by 2 into square root of 1 plus sigma square by omega square epsilon square plus 1. For alpha it is minus 1, for beta it is plus 1. We use the relation to find out what is beta for good dielectrics. Substitute 1 plus sigma square omega square whole power half, already we have derived that. So that is equal to, beta is equal to omega into square root of mu epsilon by 2 into, what this term can be written as, 1 plus sigma square by omega square 2 omega square epsilon square plus 1. From this 1 plus 1 is 2. If you take 2 as common, 2 gets cancels out, it is given as omega square root of mu epsilon into 1 plus sigma square by 4 omega square epsilon square whole power half. Again, use the formula 1 plus x whole power n formula for this term. So therefore, so beta is given as omega into square root of mu epsilon into 1 plus nx, and neglect the higher order terms, that is 1 plus nx will come out as 8 omega square epsilon square. So this is the answer for your phase shift constant for good dielectrics. Now let us check out next one. Next one, velocity. Velocity, the velocity formula is velocity is equal to v is equal to omega by beta, omega by beta, where velocity, from this formula, so what is omega by beta? So omega by beta is 1 by square root of mu epsilon into 1 plus sigma square by 8 omega square epsilon square. So from this it is written as V naught into 1 plus sigma square by 8 omega square epsilon square whole power minus 1. Where, what is V naught? V naught is written as 1 by square root of mu epsilon. For this term, use this formula 1 plus x whole power minus 1 is equal to, from binomial expansion, 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube plus so on. Neglect higher order terms as sigma by omega epsilon ratio is very, very less than 1. So therefore, the velocity is given as V naught into 1 minus x. What is x? Sigma square by 8 omega square epsilon square. So this is the answer for velocity, where, what is V naught? Where V naught is equal to 1 by square root of mu epsilon. Now finally, the intrinsic impedance, fourth one, the eta, the general formula for eta is j omega mu by sigma plus j omega epsilon. It is a well-known formula. From this formula, we can calculate very simply what is eta for good dielectric. Take j omega epsilon common in the denominator. So therefore, j omega mu by, take denominator, j omega epsilon as common. This that is equal to 1 plus sigma by j omega epsilon square root. Cancel j omega and j omega. It will come out as square root of mu by epsilon into 1 plus sigma by j omega epsilon whole power minus 1 by 2. Apply 1 plus x whole power n formula for this term. So therefore, eta will come out as square root of mu by epsilon into 1 minus sigma by j 2 omega epsilon, and neglect higher order terms because sigma by omega epsilon ratio is much, much less than 1. So if you take j to the numerator, so it is written as square root of mu by epsilon into 1 plus j into sigma by 2 omega epsilon. So this is the intrinsic impedance for good dielectric. So these are the four relations you have to derive.
In order to get 8 marks for this question. Alpha, this is the alpha answer. So this is the beta answer. So this is the velocity answer. This is the intrinsic impedance answer for good dielectric. So this is the answer for this problem to get 8 marks in the examination. Thank you.